Shalom, shalom, and erev tov, anashim tovim, achim ve'achayot mishpacha sheli. It is a good hump day Wednesday evening here in the Bay Area, and I thought I would post one of my favorite readings found in Sefer Tehillim, in the book of the Psalms of David HaMelech. Of course, there are so many psalms to love, so many that carry prophetic significance, so many are just simply on their face beautiful, uplifting, and encouraging. This one in particular, Psalm 126, has been a mainstay and a favorite of mine from boyhood. I remember it very, very well. And it was always on my lips. It was a part of prayers, etc. and etc. It is literally about, it's a visionary type of viewing, a hopeful viewing of when the Most High, Yud-Heh-Vav-Heh, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, when he will turn the tide of captivity and turn things back in the favor of the people. So not only is it always appropriate, this psalm, but I think it's even more now in these days, in these latter days, in these Yamim Ha'acharim, in these later or latter days, that it is very important. And I like to share it with you. Again, it's one of my favorites. It is Tehillim Psalm 1. 26. Shir Hamalot Beshuv Adonai et Shivat Tzion Hainu Kecholmim Az Yimale Schok Pinu Ulshonenu Rina Az Yomru Vogoyim Higdil Adonai לעשות עם אלה, הגדיל אדוני לעשות עמנו, היינו שמחים. שובה אדוני את שביתנו, כאפיקים ובנגב, הזורעים בדמעה, ברינה יקצורו. הלוך ילך ובחו, נושא משך הזרע, בו יבוא ורינה נושא אלומותיו. So, I'll just tell you word for word what the psalmist is saying. Of course, you're familiar with the phrase Shir Hama'alot. Shir is a song. Hama'alot is of degrees, or song of ascents, song of heights. Okay, again, it's a song that's being lifted up to the place where help can come from, a place being lifted up to the heights. Again, ma'alot should sound familiar. It sounds like aliyah, when you go up or you make your way up from a lower plane to a higher plane. La'alot, okay? So, Beshuv Adonai, however you want to use the circumlocution here. So the word shuv means return. In biblical Hebrew, be. The preposition be can also mean when, okay, with, on, or for. But in this case, beshuv, when returns, Adonai, et Shivat Zion. These two words go together. Shivat, with the Taf at the end, Shivat Zion. The captivity of Zion, literally. The captivity of Zion. So, Bishuv Adonai et Shivat Zion. When the Most High returns the captives of Zion, or even just the captivity itself of Zion, when he turns it in the opposite direction, Hayinu ke cholmim. Hayinu, we were, with the new ending, Anachnu, Eloheinu. That new ending should give you an indication that it carries a connotation of we and or us. Hayinu, okay, a form of the verb to be. We were ke cholmim. So that preposition ke means like, okay? Cholmim are those who dream, okay? Chalom in Hebrew is a dream. Chalom, chalomot is the plural form, okay? But when it comes to cholmim, it's in the form where it is those who dream, okay? Kecholmim. So when he turned or switched the path of captivity toward freedom, we were like those who dreamed. Az, then, is the Hebrew word az, very similar to the word in Arabic, izin, okay? Az yimale schok pinu. Yimale, was filled, schok. Should sound familiar. This is Isaac's name, Yitzchak. Schok is laughter. Pinu is our mouths. Pinu, okay? Pe is a mouth. P, my mouth. Pinu, our mouths. Az yimale, then was filled. Schok, laughter. Pinu. Then our mouths were filled with laughter. Okay? What else? Ulshonenu. So lashon in Hebrew is the tongue. Is the tongue, and it can also be language as well, okay? But they're speaking specifically of mouth. We're going to take into fact that the context therefore demands that it's not speaking of language necessarily directly, but he's speaking of the tongue. Ulishonenu, and our tongues, okay? So again, there's that new ending there, yes? The new ending there that I mentioned to you that gives the connotation of us or we, just like hayinu, we were, kecholmim, as those who dreamed. Az yimale schok pinu, our mouths were filled with laughter. Ulshonenu, and our tongues, rina. Rina is joyful or jubilant singing. Joyful or jubilant singing. Az, there's the word again, then. Az yomru vagoyim, then. Then they said among the nations, Vagoyim, Higdil Adonai, Lasot im ele. Higdil, the root word of Higdil is Gadol, Gimel Dalet Lamet. Gadol is the opposite of Katan. Gadol is great or big, large, okay? In this case, with the hay in front of it, it is causative, Higdil, okay? Greatly. Adonai has done with these. La'asot im ele. Greatly has Adonai done with these. And then here comes the affirmation. We don't need you to tell us. We're going to go ahead and we're going to verify it. Higdel Adonai la'asot imanu. There's that new ending again. Greatly has the Most High done with us. Okay? Hayinu. Smechim, and whereof, or therefore, we are glad. Here comes a plea. Shuva. This is a plea. Please turn back, or please cause to roll the other way. Shuva. Adonai et shvitenu. There's that new ending again. Shvitenu means our captivity. So, shuva. Adonai et shvitenu. Please turn again our captivity. Ka'afikim ba'negev. Now, this is beautiful here. Ka'afikim ba'negev. Okay, so afik or afikim is like streams. It's streams. It's individual bustling streams of water. Imagine dead, dry ground. Okay, like in Sahara, il-Sahara, in a desert. But imagine streams, multiple streams of water bursting into dry ground. It's reviving that dry ground, and it's bringing life again. So this David is saying, please turn again our captivity. Ka'afikim ba'negev, like streams in the desert, just bursting in all multiple directions and bringing life with it. Hazoraim, those who plant, bedim'a. Okay, so dim'a, okay, is it's a tear, like that comes from your eyes when you're crying, okay? Dim'a. Dima'ot is the plural form, dima'ot, but I'm sorry, I skipped hazorim. Okay, so zera is the root of this word. Zain, resh, ein, zera is a seed. Is a seed, yes? But in this case, again, zoraim is the one who seeds or the one who plants. So therefore, hazoraim bedim'a, the ones who plant tearfully, berina yiktsoru, in jubilant singing, they will harvest, or they will reap the harvest, okay? Yiktsoru, okay? Kof, okay? Tzadi and resh is the root of the word to harvest, okay? Haloch yelech, haloch yolech, hayo, haloch yelech, excuse me, haloch yelech. It's a doubling up. Hebrew does this on occasion with the same word in a different form, but it's saying, go, surely we'll go. Uvacho. Okay, so it's saying, in essence, let me make sure this makes sense. It's giving the connotation of the one who carries the seed. So we have to finish the thought. Haloch yelech uvacho nosei meshech hazara. Okay, so here's the subject of this particular part. Nosei meshech hazara. This is the one who bears the seed. So go, surely will go in tears, the one who bears the seed or carries the seed. Bo yavo verina nosei alomotav. So again, this last part is the subject of the last part of this sentence. Okay, it is nosei alomotav, okay, the one who bears the sheaves of grain. So put it together here. Go, surely we'll go. Haloch yelech uvacho. Go, surely we'll go in tears, the one who bears the seed, who is bearing and carrying the heavy seed. Bo yavo verina. Come, surely we'll come in jubilant singing. Nose alumotav, the one who is carrying the sheaves of grain. So you can see the contrast there, that the one who goes carrying the heavy sack of seed, doing the work, right? He will do so in tears. But at the end, because of his hard work, come, surely will come. The one who is bearing the sheaves of grain, he will come with jubilant singing. This is a picture of redemption. This is a picture of not only harvest, literally, with the from the standpoint of hachlaut or agriculture, but the sheaves of grain, harvest time and plenty, shefa, shefa, abundance and being satisfied. It's also talking about the people as well. Remember, the fields are white and ripe for harvest, right for harvest, okay? All right, I hope you've enjoyed this reading of one of my favorites, Psalm 126. I will read through again, and we will be done. Shir ha'ma'alot b'shuv Yehovah et shivat Zion hayinu kecholmim az yimale שחוק פינו ולשוננו רינה. אז יאמרו וגויים, יגדל יהוה לעשות עם אלה, יגדל יהוה לעשות עמנו, היינו שמחים. שובה יהוה את שביתנו כאפיקים בנגב, הזורעים בדמעה, ברינה יקצורו, Haloch yelech uvacho noshe meshech hazara. Bo yavo verina noshe alumotav, alumotav. Okay, everybody. I am I am feeling confidence in the spirit and prayerfully that you will all have a great night, restful sleep, and that your bodies will be renewed and you will be ready for the next day. And of course, with Yom Shishi Friday afterwards coming, when the sun sets, the Shabbat is coming. Until the next time, everyone, titchadesh, titchadesh, and titchadesh. Be renewed, be renewed, and be renewed. Watch, fight, and pray. Shalom.